Fright fans, welcome into day 10 of our 13 days of Halloween countdown, our Ratober countdown, where we're counting down 13 rat movies to celebrate the Halloween season. Now, yesterday we looked at the movie Trilogy of Terror 2, a good little horror anthology film. Today we're going to look at something else. Unfortunately, dealing with a rat problem here. They're all over the place. The exterminator never returned to the office. Not sure what's going on. I'm gonna have to go down and look for him again. I keep getting phone calls from his office, won't know where he's at. But before we get to that, I'm gonna pick another movie. We just got a few left in here. What's gonna be day 10's entry? All right, today we're gonna look at a classic movie from the 1930s, one that you probably weren't expecting to see pop up on this countdown, but when you think about it, it makes total sense. And I'm talking about Nosferatu. Nosferatu was an unofficial adaptation of the Bram Stoker Dracula novel by German director F.W. Murnau that was almost lost forever after a court battle ruled in favor of the Stoker estate that it violated copyright, and all prints of the film were ordered destroyed. Fortunately, some of the prints survived intact, as this is one of the scariest vampire films of all time. Nosferatu's vampire is called Count Orlok, a tall, rat-like figure with a bald head, large protruding incisors, pointy ears, and long claws. Orlok travels by ship from Transylvania to the town of Wisburg, Germany, bringing with him coffins full of fresh dirt and a multitude of rats, which swarm from the coffins onto the bank, spreading disease and pestilence. The vampire himself is a plague, a sickening visage more animal in appearance than human. This silent film is one of the best vampire films of all time. It was remade in 1979 by director Werner Herzog, starring Klaus Kinski as the Count, Dracula this time, not Orlok. And that version also featured rats prominently. It's rumored that the witch director, Robert Eggers, is working on a new adaptation as well, but as of this time, nothing has come of that yet. That's right, Nosferatu. I added that one to the list because rats are such an important part of this story. Every version of it has rats highly involved. They go along hand in hand with Nosferatu. The rats are an important part of the story. They're all over the place. They are a plague. They carry plague and pestilence, just like the plague of vampirism. They're symbolic for the plague of vampirism coming over it with Nosferatu. Is his plague of rats carrying the Black Death. So anyway, they're a big part of the film of Nosferatu, which is why I added this film into this countdown. Plus, he looks like a rat with that bald head and teeth and pointy ears and the long claws. Definitely one of the more horrific representations of a vampire in cinema. Very rat-like with those long front teeth. So anyway, I think it fits, and there it is. Day 10's entry is Nosferatu. All right, well, I'm gonna see if I can find where this exterminator's at so his company will quit calling me. In the meantime, be sure and join me back here tomorrow night for another rat movie. And remember to stay mad.